Hey everybody, Smooth Terrorist here, and I'm back. You know, since I came back to YouTube, it's kind of left me flat. I've been trying to get that old 2006-2007 feeling back, you know, when this place was entertaining and lively, and there was drama flying around and hurt feelings and cum and blood and ectoplasm everywhere, and it just hasn't been that way. You know, for the two or three of you that saw the straight dope debate thing I did, I apologize. I know it was like sitting through church. I don't think either one of us anticipated that would be so boring. But a week ago, I saw a video about me by a guy named Agent Timex. And he has since taken that video down. But luckily, even though I didn't have time to record a response, I did have time to download it. And this video is... It's a work of art. I'm not being a smartass here. I'm serious. I applaud this video because it's like proto drama. It's like paleo drama. It's like drama the way it used to be back before Google bought YouTube and made it suck. So without any further ado, I present to you Steve-O from Jackass.
So, fake Sagan. You know, a long while back I saw Straight Dope's video expose on this guy, and I admit, maybe at the time as a result of that, my opinion about fake Sagan was kind of skewed, because while for the most part I consider Straight Dope to be pretty objective in his observations about other people, I understood the point of that video was to rail against this guy. So as a result of watching that video, the first impression that I happened to get of fake Sagan was that he was one of the most unintentionally hilarious people that I've seen in a while, besides you know who.
I don't know who, actually. Are you talking about Brett Keane? Are you talking about the Amazing Atheist? You could be talking about fucking anyone! There's a lot of hilarious people on YouTube. There's a lot of unintentionally hilarious people on YouTube. I think you're one of them. But it's good to know that most of what you have to say about me is going to be based on things you saw in a Straight Dope video. That means this'll be familiar territory.
Nonetheless, and this was a while ago, I had no intention of making a video about the guy. But over the last year, he just keeps coming up. Because he's one of those Q-list YouTube celebrities.
Hey. I will have you know, sir, that I am well ensconced in the P-list.
And there's a few friends of mine on my list in YouTube who favored his videos. And I got mixed opinions about The Amazing Atheist. You know, sometimes I watch his videos, and I know Fake Sagan is one of that guy's butt buddies, so he ends up popping up in my recommended videos all the time. So for a while now, I've been being repeatedly exposed to his antics. And I've gotten the chance to see a few of his videos completely unedited, because sometimes when I'm bored, I'll click anything. So of course, once again, he shows up in my recommended videos, and I just happen to watch one of his videos earlier tonight. And
blah, 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 blah. Are you gonna fucking do that thing that everybody does? See, let me go off on a little tangent here for a minute. You know how when you're watching an action movie, like let's say it's a buddy cop film, there's always gonna be that inevitable scene where like the partner gets shot or something, and he's like laying there gasping for breath, and you know it's like, when you see my wife, tell her that I love her. Just do me one favor, get the son of a bitch who did this. Oh. And you know you're sitting there like, oh fuck, seen it, because it's a cliche, right? Well, you know, I'm starting to think that drama videos have been around long enough to be kind of a de facto art form, so they have cliches the same way books and movies and music and everything else does. And the worst cliche that I've identified in the genre of ownage, ponage drama videos is that fucking... annoying little preamble everyone has to do where they, like, explain ad nauseum why the person that they're about to rant about for 10 minutes isn't really important or worth their time. Oh, I don't really know who this
fake Sagan smooth terrorist guy is. He comes up in my list all the time, and he's friends with the amazing... I'm not friends with the amazing atheist, by the way. Shows how much you know. This guy's really not worth my time, but I just had a fucking 30 minutes to blow out my ass for whatever reason. I'm gonna make this video. Shut the fuck up, man. You know who I am. You know who the fuck I am. You're talking about me. You're gonna talk about me for 10 fucking minutes.
From what I gather, he compares too many things to his own experiences, and I'll explain this. And I could start specifically by explaining what bothered me about his censorship and freedom video. And don't mistake me here, I'm not talking in defense of the idea of censorship as it is today in general.
But that's exactly what you're going to do! Now don't get me wrong, I'm not defending censorship, but I'm gonna sit here and defend censorship.
I'm just using this as an example of part of what irks me about fake Sagan. What kind of made me snicker when I was watching this video was his ideas about what motivates the particular people that are doing the censoring. The thing that made me laugh out loud by myself in my room while I was watching this video was when he claimed that censorship was, in part at least, driven by jealousy. As in, you know, if somebody wants to censor pornography, it must be because they have a tiny dick. And if someone wants to censor art, oh, it's because of their own lack of artistic ability. I agree, censorship and general can and does get taken overboard in a lot of situations.
No. See, right there, you revealed who you are and what you're about. Because I don't think censorship gets taken overboard. I think any censorship at all is overboard. Right? There's no right amount of censorship. There's no moderate amount of censorship, okay? Any censorship at all is a bad thing.
And granted, there could be a lot of situations where people do censor people because they are jealous. But I wouldn't go as far as to call that principle universal regarding the idea of censorship in general. So he kind of stretches this idea out to imply, you know, that people want to censor his girlfriend's video because they're jealous of it.
Oh boy. No, you're mixing two separate, unrelated videos into one monstrous strawman chimera that I never fucking said. Okay, I made one video about Ocean Avani's video, Ocean Avani was my girlfriend at the time, which got removed from YouTube because it had cartoon boobies in it. Okay? And then I made another video years after the fact about censorship in the mainstream media, cinema, TV. And you're mixing them. They don't have anything to do with one another.
And to me, the first thing this guy's got to realize is that YouTube is not his personal property. It doesn't belong to any of us. Sadly, it does belong to a select few people that are trying to appeal to their corporate sponsors. And yeah, it sucks, but it's up to them personally to make the judgment call as far as what of this content is going to offend their corporate sponsors too much and make them stop making money off of the website. It's not up to fake Sagan. It's not up to you. It's not up to me. And I've had a few videos taken down, and these are videos with no tits or no ass in them whatsoever. It's just me sitting in a camera talking, just like I am right now. And when my video gets taken down, I realize the fact that it's someone else's discretion as to whether or not my video should remain on their website. I may laugh, I may try to re-upload it, but I never make the ridiculously childish implication that somebody deleted it because they're jealous of it. That's fucking retarded.
Yeah, that is a pretty fucking retarded assertion to make, which is probably why I never fucking made it! I challenge you, Agent Timex, to find a clip of me saying that Ocean Avani's video got removed from YouTube because the YouTube staff were jealous of her artistic talent. You won't fucking find that, because I never said it. You're stupid, you're making a straw man argument, stop it. You know, I'm really tired of this mealy-mouthed, obsequious attitude people have about censorship on here. Everyone's rushing to the defense of the YouTube executives, and their right to censor the rest of us. Like their rights are being infringed because I want to say what I want when I make a fucking video. Look, okay, YouTube may have started out as a little flash-in-the-pan, mom-and-pop video site, but it's grown since then. It's broken all bounds. It's become a place where political candidates have debates on YouTube. I think it's pretty important to stand up for our right to free speech on here. And the real point is that YouTube has transitioned into infrastructure, communications infrastructure, right? It's part of a long progression. It started with the telegraph and then the telephone, and this is the next thing. It's how we communicate with each other. And YouTube is like the next Ma Bell. They're just a monopoly that's using that infrastructure to turn a profit at the rest of our expense. I've made this argument before, and I know it's not exactly analogous, but your cell phone plan is privately owned. Does that mean that Verizon can tell you what you are and are not allowed to say during a phone conversation? The idea of that pisses you off, right? Because you recognize that the phones are infrastructure. It's something we all use. It's commonly held. It's for the common good. It's infrastructure, right? It's like the sidewalk. It's like the street. It's going to be a long time before you guys fucking figure this out. And I'm tired of this. It's capitalism, buddy. They gotta protect their sponsors. They can do whatever the fuck they want. You don't like it, go to Russia. Fuck you. Fuck you, okay? If you don't stand up for your right to free speech, you're not gonna have it.
I can relate this principle to my own life because I'm a manager at where I work, and when it comes down to it, there's a decision that you have to make. When I'm required to enforce a rule on my subordinates at work that's handed down from above, because that happens to be part of the system of how we operate our business, you know, people gripe and moan about it all the time. I've heard all kinds of shit about myself. They'll judge me. I've heard that I'm high and mighty, that I'm power tripping and it's going to my head and all this shit. And I realize, you know, I have people there that just simply don't understand the position I'm in.
Oh, you're interrupting this drama video to have a little ego party for yourself, aren't you? I hope you're not like a crew chief at McDonald's or something talking all that.
And they'll try to fill in the blanks with their own little reasoning, but it's usually childishly driven, just like I'm seeing in this fake Sagan video that I'm talking about. But when it comes down to it, you have a decision to make. Is this bad enough that I want to quit my entire job over it? And really, that's the only thing you're allowed to decide in your position. Because the door's right there, you're not a slave, no one's holding you here, you're not chained to your frigging workstation. So that's your decision to make.
That's the only decision that you can make is whether to stay and accept the inequitable conditions or just leave and quit and starve on the street. No. There are other options, like organizing, like striking, like locking out the building. There's a lot of fucking things you can do.
But, you know, you're not going to keep your foot in the door and try to change things through little tactics like whining and making personal judgments about people who are trying to enforce these rules upon you. And the same thing applies to this setting in YouTube. You can either post your videos here or you can fucking leave. And the choice is yours. Just don't think if you attack somebody personally, they're going to go, oh, I see the error of my ways. We can do things your way now. Because it's just not realistic. And yes, I take into account the possibility that maybe, you know, the reason for Fake Sagan making this video...
You mean the fantasy video in your head that I never actually made?
...was to commiserate with other YouTubers. It's like my employees at work. If y'all want to bitch to each other about stuff, I don't care. Just don't come to me with that shit and pretend it's going to have any bearing on my decision either way. I mean, yeah, everybody's free to express their opinion about everything. But unfortunately, where you express this opinion and who you express it to is not going to be up to you in a lot of situations. No matter how unjust you think that idea is or how un-American you think it is. Because some people just aren't going to want to hear it, and I think that has a lot to do with the idea that there are people out there that abuse the idea of expressing their opinion.
You know, I hear what you're saying, Agent Timex, and I just find myself, like, absentmindedly wondering if that hat you're wearing has a reservoir tip. Jackass. Look, what is with this slave mentality that we're starting to develop about free speech? Well, yeah, I support free speech. I'm a big First Amendment guy, but there's a time and place for free speech. You know, the time is when you're in your house. You know, just stay home and you can say whatever the hell you want, because we're all free. It's a free country, right? Actually, dig a bunker, dig a trench, and when you're 50 feet below the Earth's surface, where you can't offend anybody's tender sensibilities or hurt any profits. That is not free speech. It's not free speech if you have to hide.
A big part of what I don't respect about Fake Sagan is that he is so obviously afraid. He is scared shitless of the idea that you might see through his act and see him for what he is. He doesn't want you looking at him outside of the conditions that he tries to so tightly control. He just smacks of this effort at projecting this image of himself.
I'm a PR mastermind. I really am. It's like Wag the Dog on the Smooth Terrorist channel. I'm so concerned with tightly controlling my image, and that's why I make videos drunk and do blog TV broadcasts on mescaline and get pissed drunk in fundraisers. I don't give a fuck. This is me. Accept it.
I can look at him and how he acts and how he speaks and how he moves and how he tries to put it all together. And you could tell he's really trying to convince you that he's this tough guy who's really cool and has a superior intellect. And when I see this, my brain tends to go the opposite way. What I think is that he really doesn't want you to think that he is a stupid, weak, little dweeb. And that
no, of course I want you to think I'm a stupid, weak, little dweeb. Who wouldn't, right?
Falls in line with a few of the things he said and the way he acted on that live blog TV or whatever it was spot that they did for that free speech vids in the documentary that Straight Dope covered. Because he was drunk as shit in that, in case you don't remember. And when you're drunk, the truth comes out.
When you're drunk, the truth comes out. You got that from Straight Dope, along with just about everything else that you said in your video. You know, the ancient Romans used to say, in vino veritas, which is Latin for the truth is in wine. So they believe the same thing that you and Straight Dope do. But we've learned a little bit about neuroscience in the past few thousand years, and that's actually not really true. I just do this little mental exercise, okay? If what you were saying was true, then imagine what Guantanamo Bay would be. It would be like happy hour, nonstop, right? They wouldn't waterboard people. They'd like Jägermeister board people. That doesn't work. When you're pissed drunk, some of what you say might be true, and a lot of it's just going to be nonsensical bullshit.
Video that I'm talking about, he's sitting there with his glass of wine like this, and he's got this smarmy fucking look on his face, and he's talking in this low voice. I think he's lowering his voice so he sounds bigger and tougher than he really is. I think we heard his real voice when he was drunk in that live TV spot that I was telling you about.
And you know, I'm tired of people accusing me of being a phony just for having vocal range. I have a lot of range to my voice. Listen, check this out. Low. Right? But those were both my voice, okay? The low is me. The high is me! They're both me, okay? It's not like I have a voice changer box like, you know, you hang up with me again, Sydney, I'm gonna gut you like a fish. Scream reference. You were probably 8 years old when that movie came out.
Everything he does is this carefully controlled effort to project the opposite of what he had been considered as when he felt like a victim. And when I see stuff like that, people just stink of fear to me. And I think everybody gets this kind of feel from certain people, like the little short guy that wants to challenge everybody to a fight because maybe he got punked in front of a few people. So now he desperately wants everyone to think he's tough. He's trying to overcompensate now for being put in a position where his power was taken away from him. And he's trying to
where my power got taken away from me? You sound like a rape counselor or something. Which is ironic since you look like a date rapist. Don't watch so much Dr. Phil.
Take it all back by taking these actions, but what a lot of these people don't realize is that they wouldn't be taking these actions in the first place if these things weren't done to them that made them feel powerless to begin with. And that applies to this Fake Sagan guy. The people who were picking on you managed to change you. They formed your personality into something that it wouldn't have been otherwise. They beat you.
Nuh-uh, man, they never beat me. They, whoever they is, they never beat me, man. I'm invincible, man, my whole life. I never got picked on once. I came out of my mom's cunt, like, fucking 6'4" and full of muscle and, Isn't that from that song, like The Land Down Under or whatever. You know, I've never been mistreated or ridiculed or picked on in any way. My whole life has been perfect, man. You wish you were me. No, of course I've been fucking picked on before. Everybody has. You know, I don't even believe that there are such things as bullies and victims, because we're all both. You know, if you think back on your day, you can probably think of a few instances where you felt trodden upon, where you felt like you were being victimized or bullied or pushed around or whatever, but you probably don't remember any instances during the day where you picked on somebody else. That isn't because it didn't happen, it's because you didn't notice it. You didn't realize it, right? Like it's not illegal when the president does it. You know, it's that kind of, it's like a double standard that we all have. We each have that double standard. So we don't see when we're being the bully. But as far as the whole they beat you thing goes, you know, I haven't thought about it in years. And you actually made me think about this. But in the 4 years that I was in high school, there were no less than 3 students who committed suicide. And I haven't thought about that in a long time because I didn't know any of them personally. I didn't know one of those 3. You know, it's just like you'd hear rumors in the hallway and then there'd be a little memorial service and it's like, oh, somebody killed themselves. Wild. But the point I'm making is, like, they got beaten, not me, because I'm here, you know, making drama videos with your goofy-looking ass. I mean, I'm the person I am, and maybe getting picked on turned me into, like, a cynical, angry person, but I like being a cynical, angry person. I mean, this is where I live. This is how I exist. I wouldn't want to be, like, some happy-go-lucky, cheerful, sunny disposition, vacuous douche. Like, I'm glad I'm angry. I'm glad I'm a spiteful, pissed off motherfucker. I'm kind of in love with my own image, if it doesn't show. You kind of accuse me of that. But you know, the point is, enemies are important. Your friends are the people, I think, who appreciate you for who you are. But your enemies are the people who make you who you are. So I'm grateful to every one of my enemies. My haters make me famous, and that includes you.
And the fact that some people let these things change them into this douchebag who puts so much effort into projecting this facade is just really ironic and really sad to me, and I tend to see right through it. So fake Sagan is very self-aware, and to me at least, that's ridiculously obvious. I hope he realizes, and people like him, I hope you realize when people watch you, they're gonna look carefully through all this Wizard of Oz shit behind the curtain to see the weak little stupid dweeb at the control board, and they're gonna see how scared you are. And every time you call somebody a pussy, they're gonna realize it was because you were called a pussy. And they're gonna take into account how much that must have hurt you for you to consider it such an effective weapon towards other people.
Let me get this straight. Every single thing I do, say, and everything I am is directly caused by the fact that I was, like, victimized at some point. So, like, everything I do is just a response to being a victim of something, right? So if I call you a pussy, that means it's because somebody at some point down the line called me a pussy, right? I don't care, I'm still gonna call you a pussy. Pussy, 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 pussy.
And that type of person will always be somebody that I have little to no respect for. But hey, maybe I'm just saying this stuff because I'm jealous of how cool and tough he is.
I suppose that is possible. I am a pretty tough guy. And cool. But this is YouTube, so I think it's more likely that you were just talking about me for attention and views and subscriptions, and I'd like to think you're jealous of me, but I don't know. You did touch the back of your neck, though, when you said that. When you said, oh, maybe I'm just jealous of how tough and cool fake Sagan is. That's called a tell. That's something people do when they're lying. You know, like, yeah, I didn't borrow your car and put a scratch in it. I don't know anything about that. So maybe you really are jealous of me. I have no idea. You should be, though. Anyway, I was also featured in the recently released epic feature-length, hour-and-a-half-long question-and-answer video by The Amazing Anus. I never would have found the part that's about me, number one, because I haven't watched TJ's videos in years since they started sucking. Even when we were friends, I wasn't watching his videos. It was a point of contention, because he'd be like, hey, did you see that video I made? And I'd be like, oh, yeah, video. But anyway, that, and like, it's so fucking long that you're trying to search for things in there, and it's just an hour and a half, blah, 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 blah. But luckily someone sent me the link, so I have it right here. It's audio only, so I guess I'll go ahead and respond in real time instead of splicing clips and all that. Here we go.
It probably won't, because it gets ratings. I assume it does, anyway. Where does TJ see himself in 10 years? I don't know. Dead in a ditch.
We can hope.
My own sick.
Actually,
Cody,
that's
still
possible.
Around? No, Cody's dead. He died in a fire. What about your friend Case as well? Case pointed a gun at my head like a faggot and said, are you afraid? So, he can die.
You know, a number of people have asked me since this video was released if that's true or not. Let me clear the air right now. It is.
He's a miserable pussy. He is a pseudo-anarchist who claims to be an anarchist, but then leeches off of his ex-girlfriend's disability checks. He is a pathetic lowlife. And,
wait for it.
You know, any misfortune that he encounters in the future is well deserved. Does that answer your fucking question?
Okay, I don't even know where to fucking begin with this shit. I think TJ did that on purpose to flummox me. Like he knew that much idiocy packed into 5 seconds would just make me go like... No, let's get to one thing at a time. First of all, what the fuck does leeching off somebody's disability check have to do with being an anarchist? Are anarchists like successful, independent entrepreneurs or something? Like that was just a non sequitur. It didn't make any fucking sense. Second of all, the whole you leech off your ex-girlfriend's disability check thing came from Galen. That's a halcyon thing, and it's not exactly inspirational to see that you've been reduced to, like, ripping off Galen now. I guess now that you're not friends with me, and you're not friends with Cody anymore either, from what I've heard, your list of like, sources to draw material off is getting thin, right? Because for those of you who don't know, TJ's idea of friendship is just to, like, perpetually fucking leech shit off of you. Like the niggot thing, N-I-G-G-G-O-T, yeah, that was me, like, along with, like, a shitload of other stuff he said in his videos. In fact, you couldn't even get through this video without ripping me off. Allow me to demonstrate. Let me see if I can find the right time here. I think it's, 57, I think. Let's see.
Has a leg up on us by any significant portion of time. Then again, we've always sort of excelled at building weapons, so...
No, it must be 58.
Be more efficient at it.
Okay, wait.
Has a leg up
on us. God damn, this video is so big.
$45. How do you feel about roast beef? It's awesome.
You're a windbag, TJ.
A cowboy with lots of fucking gravy. TJ, do you like your left hand or your right hand to jack off into? My right hand seems to be more efficient at it. It seems to handle the task a lot better. But I know a lot of people like their left now because they can more easily manipulate their mouse with the right hand. But I'm somewhat ambidextrous.
Yeah, and here again, another fucking piece of a conversation that I had with TJ winds up in one of his videos, even though we're not fucking friends anymore. I mentioned to TJ one time that I thought the information age had revolutionized my masturbatory habits because, like, I had to switch from the right hand to the left since I use the mouse with the right hand, and there it is in your fucking video. We're not even friends anymore, and you're still fucking pumping me for material. And I guess now that you can't seem to keep any friends except for the one friend who acts like your sycophantic butler. That's pretty telling, by the way. I guess now your list of people to rip off has gotten short. But let's address this accusation itself. The whole you mooch off your ex-girlfriend's disability check thing. You know, I told Ocean that you and Galen were both saying that about me, and her immediate reaction was, well, they're hypocrites. But nobody in the audience is going to understand why you guys are hypocrites, so let me fill in the blanks. In the years that I've known TJ and Galen, which is more years for TJ than Galen, but I've known them both for a while, neither one of these motherfuckers has ever held down one job. No paychecks, no W-2s, no nothing. You've never had a fucking job while I've known you, TJ. It's unbelievable to me that you would take that tack. And furthermore, it isn't true. In the years that I've lived with Ocean, and, you know, for those who don't know, not that anyone cares, we're not dating anymore, we're just, like, she's like my best friend. She's my best friend. We've lived together for a long time, and in that time, we've had, like, 5 apartments. I think 2 of them were in my name, and 3 of them were in her name. But I've always paid half the rent and half the bills, and I've always held down jobs during that time, except for maybe, like, a few gaps where between employment, none of which would be longer than, like, 2 or 3 months at the most. Not to mention the fact that, like, I have a car and she doesn't, so whenever she needs to go somewhere, I'm the one that takes her. And, you know, it's just ridiculous. I'm not going to pull out pay stubs on camera if you decide to press this. And, like, oh, here I'm a working man. Like, fuck you. Everybody knows I fucking work, and everybody knows your lazy ass doesn't. And I'm forced to wonder, TJ, if it's ever occurred to you that maybe one of the faceless suckers that you routinely solicit donations from is on disability. Maybe you actually do what you're accusing me of doing. Not that you would fucking care, right? Because you think that you're just so charming and entertaining, that should be what you do for a living, right? You know, TJ, if anyone's a fucking mooch, it's you. And by the way, this free speech videos thing, I know it's back. I know it, he's doing it again. I don't know what the website is called now, but I think I heard he raised like $3,000 for it. To everyone who's donated, let me tell you this right now, okay? You're not going to get that website. You might get your name on, like, a commemorative plaque in McDonald's or something, because that's where all the money is going. He never had any fucking intention of making it. He's not going to make it. Give up. Now, you may be wondering, does that make me a hypocrite because I participated in the 666 fundraiser for free speech videos? And the answer is no, because I was in the same boat with you. I was a sucker. I got duped. I thought there was really going to be I wasn't in on the scam. I didn't know that he never had any intention of making free speech videos, and he was just going to spend all the money on his fucking self. But the point is, you know, if anybody is a fucking drain, it's you. If anybody is a fucking mooch, it's you. Okay? I have 2 jobs, TJ. You don't have 1, unless you count YouTube, which I'm sure you do. Anyway, the whole mooch off the disability thing, it was lame when Galen said it. It's lame now that you're saying it. And the worst part about this is, it's really not that different from what Meta Bob did and Captain Awesome did, which is, to try to use Ocean to get to me. So why is it that every time somebody's got a problem with this guy, all they can talk about is Ocean Devani? Stop using her as my Achilles heel. She's not. She gives me strength because she's my best friend and I love her. And it's like, I'm never going to start caring about this bullshit. I'm never going to start caring about, like, Hal taste my pee-pee and, you mooch off somebody. I guess just by living with a disabled person, that means I'm a mooch off their disability, right? So disabled people should just be hermits, right? And not have any friends. Fuck you. And by the way, stop doing this whole, like, trying to be the next sexy Phil thing where your videos are all, you know, highly polished and produced and like you only talk about whatever's in the headlines that day. Like it's done to death. Everybody fucking does it. You're not the only one. At least at first when you came on YouTube, you were fucking original. That's when I used to watch your videos. These days, they suck. I know you're not asking for advice, but I'm giving it to you as one ex-friend to another. Stop what you're doing. It's lame. It's garbage. And I guess that's all I have to say. I could, like, do a low blow and mention the banana thing, but I can't even wrap my fucking head around that. Which is the opposite of the end that you wrapped around it. Ba-doom! Oh, fuck. I couldn't resist. I couldn't hold back. I'm sorry. But anyway, you're a douchebag. I don't fucking mooch off Ocean Devani. I pay my own fucking way in life. As far as being a pseudo-anarchist, like, whatever. This has been The Smooth Terrorist, and if you enjoyed this video, download it, re-upload it, make it your own, parody it, because Google can't censor me unless you let them. Keep it smooth.